тренеры Александр Ковалев и Александр Ермолинский.
Assistant coaches Александр Ермолинский and Александр Ковалев.
Сегодняшний матч будет судить бригада арбитров в следующем судейском составе.
The following officials are judging this game.
Старший судья Эрес Гурьон, Израиль.
Crew chief Эрес Гурьон, Israel.
Судья Мехди Ди Фалан, Франция.
Referee Мехди Ди Фалан, France.
Судья Мартинс Козловицкис, Латвия.
Referee Мартинс Козловицкис, Латвия.
И комиссар сегодняшнего матча Томислав Йованчич, Сербия.
Commissioner Томислав Йованчич, Serbia.
И прямо сейчас, милые барышни, примите эти подарки от правительства Оренбургской области. Символ нашего края – Оренбургский пуховый плато!
Presents from the government of Orenburg region. Symbol of Orenburg region. Orenburg scarf.
И прямо сейчас, уважаемые любители большого баскетбола, ваши аплодисменты обеим командам!
Hello and welcome to Orenburg in Russia. We're about 1500 km southeast of Moscow, near the border with Kazakhstan, and it's playoff time in the FIBA Women's EuroLeague. Eight teams are vying to reach the Final Four, and the playoffs are on a best of three basis. So the first game in a possible series of three could be crucial. It's Nadezhda Orenburg region against Dynamo Kursk. This is an all-Russian affair, and it looks to be finally balanced indeed. Well, Nadezhda head coach Roberto Iniguez stated that home favourite Dawana Bonner, he reckons she's the best player in the competition, although Kayla McBride, Anna Cruz and Angelica Robinson, they've all put in big displays recently and could do so again as Orenburg looks to make history with a maiden Final Four appearance after making the Final Eight in 2013. Dynamo Kursk, they reached the prestigious competition finale in their first ever season and so are now bidding to make back-to-back spots at the event. There's little doubt that the combination of veteran Latvian legend Anette Jakobsen and the highly productive forward skills of Nkadi Ogumiki will be very, very important indeed.
Также с вами я слышу левую руку вверх. И двумя руками. Дайте шума!
Well, as is often the case in Russian basketball, I'm competing with the courtside announcer, a very enthusiastic young man. No doubt raiding the club shop for lozenges after this game. And the fact of the matter is that Nadezhda have already beaten Kursk twice this season in the Russian Premier League. But Kursk, they are highly efficient offensively as they have the best field goal record in the competition, having shot 47.2% from the field. And they also lead the way assist-wise with 18.1 assists per game. Nadezhda, they will probably have to raise their perimeter game as they've struggled hugely this season. And at 27.6%, they have the worst record from downtown of all eight teams in the competition. Well, just to remind you, there are the other three quarterfinals. Fenerbahce against Uzlakan Pak, the Polish team. Barreto Familia Schio from Italy against the defending champion ZWZ Usk Prague. And being played at the same time as this quarterfinal is the fourth quarterfinal, UWMC Yekaterinburg against Galatasaray. That is underway at the moment. We're waiting patiently here in Orenburg. It'll be Orenburg in yellow and Dynamo Kursk in the blue. Look out for number 4, Angelica Robinson from Nadezhda, a 28-year-old American who now has a Montenegrin passport. He's from the University of Georgia and a Seattle Storm player in the WNBA. Joining her, another American, Kyla McBride from Notre Dame, a San Antonio Spurs player. Dewana Bonner, number 24, from Auburn University. A two-time WNBA champion for Phoenix Mercury, played in 2009 and 2014. On your screen there with her back to us is Lindsay Harding from Duke University, 31-year-old American, and she too has another passport. She's a Belarusian. So here we go. It is Nadezhda Orenburg against Dynamo Kursk, and it is the visitors here who get the first possession. Game one of a possible three in the FIBA Women's EuroLeague. Excellent ball movement from Kursk, and they open the scoring. And it is the lady I was just talking about, Lindsay Harding. Good crowd here in Orenburg. And looking after your home court is essential. And that's a lovely move inside. Angelica Robinson ties the scores. So early days here, but super efficiency from both teams. Well, that immediately is stopped because Nika Ogumiki misses a relatively open shot. Well, the first three-point attempt is unsuccessful. And here goes Lindsay Harding. Well, initially the open shot was declined, but eventually it was taken. And Kursk with a 4-2 lead. 21 there for Kursk is Irina Osipova. It's Harding. Harding pulls up for the jumper, misses it. And the rebound by Angelica Robinson. And that's the travel. Angelica Robinson looking disappointed, but dragged a pivot foot inside. Harding. Poor pass from Harding, and it's a 2-on-1. And Orenburg, well, they missed the layup. Osipova in the low post, and 4 points to the veteran Russian national team player, Irina Osipova. Fifteen for Orenburg, Anna Cruz. And the first foul of the game results in two foul shots. Dewana Bonner disappointed that she didn't get the N1 there, but she's got two foul shots to come. Dewana Bonner averaging 16.6 points a game in the competition so far. According to her coach, Roberto Iniguez, the best player in the competition. One or two players may want to prove that the coach different on that particular point. 2 from 2 for Dewana Bonner. And some up-court pressure from Nadezhda Orenburg. Harding under a little bit of pressure. Nice move inside. Lovely pass inside as well. And Kursk lead 8-4. 7 is the French lady, Endine Mayem. Bonner inside, she's fouled again, drawing fouls as though they were going out of fashion. And immediately Dewana Bonner gets the teammates together for a little chat. Well, Before she came into this game, shooting 78%. Been to the foul line many times. She shot 58 from 74. And she's on 2 from 3 tonight. Well, 2 from 4 now. Osipova the rebound. Harding. Osipova inside, nice pass and the foul. And the and one. Great pass from Osipova. And it is Nika Ogumiki with the fadeaway shot. This lady from Stanford University, she's a 76% foul shooter, also averaging 17.7 points a game.
Natalia Zhedik, first call.
And she completes the three-point play. Big lead for Kursk early on here. They lead by 7. Anna Cruz. Duana Bonner moving a long way from the screen there. And 7. Well, that's Natalia Zhedik missing by a long way. Oh, almost great passing there, but Duana Bonner picks up the loose ball. An instant change of pace. And the rebound. The rubbish picked up by Angelica Robinson. Osipova this time not even looking at the hoop, finding a man inside free. And lovely pass from Osipova. And it is Nika Ogumiki inside again. A relatively quiet start for the home side here. Anna Cruz. No backdoor on there. There's a being made to put the ball on the floor an awful lot. And the fadeaway shot is unsuccessful. And that is Nadezhda possession. No, it's not. It's Kursk possession.
In Nadezhda, number 33.
Natalia Zhedik comes out, and in comes Natalia Anokhina. Oh, Cruz putting a lot of pressure on Harding. Another good assist from Osipova, and another 2 there for Annette Jakobsen. Yeah. Wonderful 32-year-old Latvian veteran. Remember, the star of the program, I told you, Nadezhda have beaten Kursk twice this season in the Russian League, and nothing dropping for the home side. Good recovery there from Harding. Inside again, and the foul. It's a shooting foul. The foul, I think, Duana Bonner. Yeah, that's it. I didn't think it would be too long before Nadezhda Orenburg region coach Roberto Inigo has called timeout. His team trailing by 9. And when they come out of the timeout, they'll face 2 foul shots.
Ваши громкие аплодисменты группе поддержки баскетбольного клуба «Надежда».
Энджел Робинсон, номер 4, первый пол.
Энджел Робинсон, номер 4, first пол.
The first foul against Angelica Robinson, and Kursk back to the foul line again. First shot for Nika Ogumiki, unsuccessful. Former LA Sparks player. First round pick in the 2012 WNBA draft. 16-6. Ana Cruz. Cruz again inside for the layup. Well, the defense went AWOL temporarily there. And a welcome score for Ana Cruz. Little indecision now on behalf of Kursk. And the rebound by the one of Bonner, taking control there. And she lost the dribble, or did she? No, it was knocked out of bounds by Irena Osipova. Kayla McBride. Up to Cruz. Oh, that's an amazing pass and a good score. So four without reply for Nadezda Orenburg. Natalia Anoikina there. So they come out of the timeout much better than they went into it. Nadezda Orenburg. Harding. That's the first score for some time for Dynamo Kursk, and it's ND Miem. Miem spent 9 years at the great French club Bourges. Cruz inside on the turnaround, Robinson. And that's a travel, the second travel against Angelica Robinson. So the three from Natalia Anoikina is waived. Jakobsen. Oh, that's wonderful passing. And 0-2 this time for Irena Osipova. Dewana Bonner hands off to Cruz. McBride taking it inside for the finger roll. And Dewana couldn't get the rebound. Jakobsen waits for the trailer, and that trailer, well, the ball was behind her. Gunther's veteran there, disappointed with the break. Substitutions wholesale. And a Cruz comes out. And Harding too is out, and in for the first time tonight, three to Elderbrink. 20-year-old Swede.
Number two is in.
13, Elena Beglova on for Nadezda. Here she is. McBride. And the rebound is grabbed by Dewana Bonner outside the arc even. Well, 2 3-point attempts unsuccessful from Kayla McBride. Ogumiki fakes the three. And Osipova, that's end line ball to Kursk.
Замена в команде Надежда. На площадку вышла Алена Кириллова, номер 9.
Substitution in Надежда. Number 9 is in.
In for Надежда is Elena Kirillova. Well, the steal there on the out of bounds. Sloppy out of bounds play there from Kursk. Bonner. Ask McBride for a pick. And she obliges. Bonner inside, pulls up the jumper. Good hands. Super hands indeed from Osipova. And the snake-like hands of Ogumiki grab the rebound. That was a terrific block by the veteran Osipova. Now, was that deflected? No, it wasn't. So initially good hands from Elena Kirillova, and then she withdrew her hand and let the ball float out of bounds harmlessly. Jakobsen there just remonstrating with the official, saying there was a deflection. Make sure the referee will take kindly to someone wagging finger at him. 13, Beglova. Bonner. And there's an off the ball foul. Now, who's that against? Is that Jakobsen?
Татьяна Видмар, номер восьмой, первый фол.
Татьяна Видмар, number
eight, Татьяна Видмар, her first. Very experienced Russian national team player. Bonner taking it inside. Oh, no touch off the glass there. And she gets the loose ball off Elderbrink's feet.
Nice,
terrific rebounding. Bonner inside again. Oh, wonderful defense from Kurz. What a pass! What a beautiful pass to Talia Adenuyka, trailing down the lane and lays it up. And it's a 6-point game now. Terrific pass. Jakobsen. And the foul. The foul is Angelica Robinson. Oh, she allowed Tatiana Vidmar there to go baseline.
Angel Robinson, number 4, второй фол.
Angel Robinson, number 4, second fall.
Well, Robinson on two fouls, as you clearly heard. Oh, inside. And that's a goal! Whoa, goodness me. That looked like a clean block. That's what the crowd think anyway. And Angelica Robinson having a chat with the official.
Natalia Anoikina, number 33.
Number 33, Anoikina, who got the foul, and Jakobsen is on the foul line. The crowd didn't like that call, but the referee a lot closer than any of them.
In Dynamo, number 4 is in.
And Jakobsen misses the first. He's a 78% foul shooter. Not been to the foul line too many times this season so far. Just 7 scores from 9 attempts. Oh, misses both there. And Robinson looked despairingly at the official there, hoping it was her ball, and indeed it was. So Zaslina Maiga, 19 years of age, in for the first time tonight. Number 32 for Nadezda Orenburg. Bonner goes baseline. Good defense from Ogumiki. And there's a foul on the play. I think it's Vidmar. Or was it indeed Elderbrink?
Frida Elderbrink. It was indeed.
Number 2 for
number 14
and a half seconds remaining in the first quarter.
14 falls.
Bonner is fouled, and she's fouled by Ogumiki. And Bonner is drawing fouls galore.
Namkadze Ogumiki, второй фол.
So 9 seconds remaining, and Wana Bonner on the foul line for the third time in this first quarter. She's getting all her points from the foul line tonight so far, but she capable of exploding at any particular second or so. She makes it a 5-point game. Makes it she stays at 5. And the rebound grabbed by Tatiana Vidmar. And there's the buzzer for the end of the first quarter, with Dynamo Kursk leading Nadezda Orenburg region 18-13. Remember, this is just the first game of a possible 3 in the quarterfinals of the FIBA Women's EuroLeague. And some rather disappointed looks towards the huge scoreboard above us. From the home side, trailing by 5 against a team that they've beaten twice this season in the Russian League. Watching highlights of the first quarter. Early on, most of the highlights belong to the visitors here, Dynamo Kursk. Who did score in the game? It's number 13, Zinovka. Cardi, Ogumiki, no good friends with Nika. He's on 6 points. Other players for Modesta are on 4 points. Number 33, Natalia Anokina. And Angelica Robinson. Robinson picked up 2 fouls. Oh, 2 fouls or so against Ogumiki. So that probably eases the south fouls. LiveBasketball.tv bringing you all four of the Women's EuroLeague quarterfinals. This one, Modesta Orenburg, the home side against Timo Kerr. And almost simultaneously, UWMC Katrineburg against Galatasaray. And then later on tonight, Fenerbahce versus Wisla Kanpak from Krakow in Poland. And Beretta Familia Schio from Italy against the defending champions, Swiss Prague. So, as Dynamo Kursk won the opening tap, it is Modesta Orenburg who get us underway at the start of the second quarter, trailing by 5. Nine, Elena Kirilova. That will boost the crowd. That is the Selena Maiga making it a 3-point game. It's given us a long two. Lindsay Harding. Oh. Well, the referee said nothing wrong with that as Eldering pulls up and misses the jumper. And the rebound by Kayla McBride. Bonner. Kirilova inside, misses the two, the rebound by Tatiana Vidmar. Here's Lindsay Harding. Well, good hands again from the home side. Here's Duana Bonner slowing things down, waiting for the cavalry to arrive. Good defense from Elderbrink. Good hands. Good hands there from Dean Mayhem.
Замена в команду Надежды. На площадку вышла Кейла Макбрайт, номер 21.
Substitution in Надежда, number 21 is in.
Kayla McBride back in for Надежда Оренбург. Bonner inside. Well, trying to force her way through there and getting well and truly blocked. That's a long two. Rich hits from the corner. Dynamo number 14, Ludmila Sipova. Well, wonderful footwork from Elena Beglova. Hip to pivot, put down, and reduce the arrears to 4. And the rebound, well, dropped in the hands of Jakobsen for no points. Another rebound. Good offensive rebounding from Dynamo Kursk, all to no avail. Kirilova for 3. Kirilova hits the 3. It's a 1-point game. Timeout. Dynamo Kursk. Gündüz Vetra, the 48-year-old Latvian coach of Dynamo Kursk, wants to talk things over. Well, it's given us a 2. And there's a... No one seems to know what the score was. One of the assistant coaches from Modesta Orenburg seeking clarification. Yeah, he's been giving us a 3. It was clearly way, way behind the arc. Timeout, Dynamo Kursk.
вместе поднимем ручки вверх. Выше, 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 выше. И еще раз дадим аплодисменты милым барышням. С праздником вас! Помните, что мы, мужчины, вас очень любим. С 8 марта!
Well, after the worst impression of the Spice Girls that I've ever seen, we are almost at the stage where Dinamo Kerr's timeout is over. They lead by one, having led by eight earlier on. Yeah, there was no technical foul there. Everyone was looking around at the referee to see what he called, and he was just clarifying the fact that it was indeed a three-point shot. So Ludmila Sapova gets this going again. Kursk. And this is Lindsay Harding. Osipova back in. Jakobsen. Harding, nowhere to go really. Good defense around the Cruz, but the foul. Ana Круз remonstrating with herself there. It was good defense initially, and then she just reached.
Divana Bonner, number 24.
Well, actually, it was an off-the-ball foul by Divana Bonner. Here's Harding. This is good defense from Nadezda. And the shot clock buzzer goes, but the rebound taken by Annette Jakobsen. Harding pulls up, and this time the rebound is by Kayla McBride. Oh, McBride inside! And Nadezda Orenburg go in front for the first time. And this, remember, after Dinamo Kursk have called timeout. Harding. Well, the rebound grabbed by Osipova, can't hang on to it inside, but recovers. Harding. No, that's not a good pass. Not a good angle, and terrific defense from Kayla McBride. Remember, this is just the first game of a possible three.
Number 4 is in.
And 4 back in for Nadezda, Angelica Robinson. On 2000, remember the number 4 for Nadezda. And the shot is good from Ana Круз. So it's a 3-point lead now for Nadezda. First gone very, very cold. Harding for 3. Who hits? And it's tied at 24s. Just what Dinamo needed. A big three there. Again, given as a 2. Referee looked at the table and said, yeah, just 2. Oh, good hands. Wonderful hands indeed from Nika Ogumiki. And the foul to stop the break by Elena Beglova.
Natalia Noikina, number 33.
Such small margins when you're talking about, was it a 3, was it a
2? Second fall.
So a couple of Nadezda players now on 2 fouls. Here's Harding. Jakobsen almost loses it, regains it. And finds Ogumiki for a wonderful layup, kissing it off the glass. And the lead changes hands again. And the rebound by the lady who just scored, Ogumiki. Harding. Harding inside. And the rebound, Ana Круз. End-to-end stuff here in Orenburg. Круз. Nice pass inside, wonderful pass, and Angelica Robinson completely off balance under a lot of pressure, but still capable of laying it up. Robinson moves on to 6 points, Oh, that's good hands from Cruz. And Cruz, that's an offensive foul. Initially, good play from Cruz, but good defense from Harding. Feet planted outside the no-charge circle. Wonderful courage from Harding to take that charge.
Cruz, number 15, first
fall. Cruz picks up her first foul. Remember, this is just the first game of three. The margin of victory for either team is irrelevant. They just need the W. How did that pass get there from Ogumiki? And the rebound by Angelica Robinson. McBride inside, gets a shot blocked by Irina Osipova, who began sprinting down the floor thinking the ball was hers. Possession for Nadezhda Orenburg.
Substitution in Nadezhda, number 24.
And the one of Bonner back in for Nadezhda Orenburg. Bonner yet to score a field goal. 3 points and six rebounds for her. Ana Cruz. Bonner. Still hasn't scored a field goal. The rebound there by Nika Ogumiki. Lindsay Harding. With Cruz almost all over her. Osipova can't get the rebound. And that came off a Dimo Kirst knee. Duwana Bonner there just politely talking to the referee, talking about possible foul, but two other shots blocked so far. Cruz, nice pass inside, and the foul. And the foul this time is Endine Mayem. 27-year-old French international.
And on the foul line, number seven, for Nadezhda.
It's Natalia Adnokina. On 8 points so far. Leading scorer for the home side. Making nine now. Two fouls, 8 points, or 9 points rather. No rebounds, no assists. But he's from two on that occasion. The first player to make double figures. There's Gunders Vetra. Through the water to a few of the dry cotton mouth that a lot of coaches suffer from in a tight situation. Mayem, it's two. Mayem, she now moves on to 6 points. And it's back to a 1 point lead for the home side. McBride to Bonner. Cruz. No reverse layup for Cruz. No three-pointer either. And Ogumiki the rebound. And instant outlet pass. Osipina slows things down. Ogumiki. And Jakobsen is fouled. She'll get the foul line. Annette Jakobsen, the daughter, to give her full name, married name.
Natalia Naikina, number 33.
Fails to tie the scores. Ex-Connecticut Sun, Phoenix Mercury. Kashinaberg, Fenerbahce, Mundeville, Borj, Dinamo Moscow, Spartak Moscow. With Rana Blokovic, the great Latvian player. And she's tied the game at 28, with two to go in the first half. Oh, that's a terrific layup, but she missed the layup, but she was fouled. Who's the foul against?
Irina Osipova, number 21, first foul.
Irina Osipova, number 21.
Lily wins number 21. Irina Osipova, just her first foul. Lady with her hands on her hips there, left of his screen. And Modesta regained the lead through Kayla McBride. She's an 88% foul shooter.
Kayla!
A 2-point lead for Nadezda. Osipova, well, she hit the first 4 points for her team, but hasn't shot since. Great footwork from Ogumiki, but she can't score. Just about a minute and a half to go. First half is Dewana Bonner, Grizz, McBride pulls up for the jumper, floats it in. 4-point lead for Nadezda Orenburg. Timeout in the Mokos. 87 seconds remaining in the first half. And this is Nadezda Orenburg's biggest lead of the game. It's only 4 that they've made. Gundas Vetro coach to Dinamo Kurs call his second timeout. Watching highlights of the first half. And early on it was all Dinamo Kurs. But a great fight back from the home side, Nadezda Orenburg. And it is that home side, the lead by 4. An enthralled crowd here in Orenburg. We're not far from the Kazakhstan border. We're a long, long way from the Russian capital, 1500K southeast. One of 4 quarterfinal games, 2 of them taking place at the moment. This one here in Orenburg, and the other one is in Ekaterinburg, where the visitors are Galatasaray. And you'll see all 4 quarterfinals on livebasketball.tv. And what's at stake for these 8 teams? A place in the prestigious Final 4. So after the timeout, Dynamo Kursk regroup. And here's Lindsay Harding. Osipova, Jakobsen. Osipova's wide open for a second. Good defense from McBride. Ogumiki throwing it up and getting it. What a shot from Nika Ogumiki. Oh, she threw the ball at the hoop and got the drop. 1 minute remaining, first half.
The last minute.
Well, we said
at the
top of the program, this is so finely balanced, this game. That's how it's panning out. Wana Bonner, great footwork. Can't get the roll though, but the rebound is by Angelica Robinson. The 4-point lead is restored. Robinson on 8 points now. At the moment, Dewana Bonner can't buy a field bucket, but her teammates keeping Nadezda in front. Osipova, wow, she was wide open again, didn't even look at the hoop. Here's Harding. Harding pulls over the jumper, and the rebound is by Angelica Robinson. Robinson, that's her 5th rebound. Shot clock being turned off, end of the first half. Here's Ana Cruz, looking to make it a 6-point lead if possible, or even 7. Oh, great hands from Osipova. She read the pass. And on the end of the break is Ogumiki, right on the buzzer of the first half. So, Nadezda Orenburg lead Dinamo Kursk by 2 at halftime. Great hands there from Irina Osipova. With time running out at the end of the first half, she read the pass, she intercepted it, found Nika Ogumiki for the layup, and that resulted in a score for Dinamo Kursk. It is 34-32 at halftime. As the crowd went their way to seek some kind of refreshments, we're looking at highlights of the first half, and early on it was all Dinamo Kursk. We had an 8-point lead on stage with Irina Osipova there on the fadeaway. Irina Osipova playing the recent Eurobasket for Russia, and my colleague Mark Clark was describing her as a latter-day Maddie Johnson, so many assists from the veteran. There she is again, finding Ogamiki inside. Over 34 years of age now, you would believe it, would you? Ogamiki there, 12 points to her in the first half. And then Jakobsen, 3 points out of Cruz.
4
points to her. To go with, well, one rebound, one assist. Great Spanish international. Former Rivas Tecopolis player.
Первый номер крючка оранжевого цвета.
Вратаря
350. Давай еще один.
WNBA.
И
quiet game so far.
270.
The one upon 3 points and 7 rebounds for the player. Dr. Roberto Iniguez described as the best player in the women's league at the moment.
Первый билет. Это номер 3083.
Have an awesome 21-22-101.
И еще такой же.
Алина Кирилова.
И еще один счастливый билет.
If you watch highlights of the first half, I'm sure you've enjoyed it. Make sure you're back with us in about 12 minutes for what should be an enthralling second half, with a reminder that Nezda Orenburg lead Dynamo Kursk 34-32 at halftime in game one of a possible three-game series in the FIBA Women's EuroLeague quarterfinals.
4-0-92. В конце матча на большом экране вы увидите свои номера, и мы сможем вручить вам сертификаты от наших партнеров. Это твой подарок. И вот сейчас сюда в микрофон нужно громко сказать «Вперед, Надежда!». Раз, два, три.
Вперед, Надежда!
Ваши аплодисменты! Здрасте. Так, у меня есть мяч. Сейчас, сейчас, сейчас. Кто со мной? Что, будете бросать? Ну, пойдем. Раз. Пойдем. Два. А мальчики есть у нас? Пойдем. Три. Пойдем. Четыре. Так, четверо. Разуваемся. Обувь снимаем. Четыре. Пойдем. Разуваемся. Пять. И нам еще маленький. Попадешь? Пойдем, шестым будешь. Разувайся, обувь снимай. Ну что, начнемся, кто поменьше, согласны? Кто первый бросает? Пойдем. Или хочешь второй? Первый будешь бросать? Можешь вот отсюда бросать. Сейчас, секунду. Кто со мной играет? Раз, два, три, четыре. Разулся? Там у тебя двое сапог. Можно кто-нибудь с краю встаньте, мяч подавать? Как зовут?
Алиса.
Давайте Алису поаплодируем, давайте ее поприветствуем. Три броска. Поехали. Так, хорошо. Можно чуть повыше. Есть. И третий бросок. Отлично. Два из трех. Кто дальше? Пойдем. Как вас зовут?
Ярослав.
Ярославу поаплодируем. Поприветствуем Ярослава. Оп. Давай, давай. И давай посильнее. Это Ярослав. У Ярослава энергетика. Так, давай еще разок. Давай еще. Забросить надо. На тебя весь город смотрит. Еще, 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 еще. Давай, давай, давай. Так, еще. Давай, бросай. Пока не попадешь, не уйдем. Давай еще. Последний. Давайте Ярославу поаплодируем. В следующий раз у тебя получится. Пойдем сюда. Как зовут?
Данил.
Данил? Давайте, давайте Данилу поаплодируем, поприветствуем его. Три попытки. Так, не спеши. Не спеши. С разбегу? Хорошо. Как скажешь. Здесь должны быть громкие аплодисменты. Еще один бросок. Данил решил покорить наши сердца. Лучше бы ты оттуда бросал, да? Давай мяч, спасибо. Пойдем. Как тебя зовут?
Степан.
Степану аплодисменты. Оп. Тебя можешь на руки поднять? Давай, я тебя подниму на руки. Давай. Дайте нам еще разок мячик. Давай. Еще разок. Надо попасть, на тебя мама смотрит. Давай еще раз. Давай последний. Аплодисменты Степану. Ну, не расстраивайся, все получится. Так, почему в обуви? Да, ответ у нас есть. Я выиграл. Кто? Пойдем. Как зовут? Светлана, ваши аплодисменты. Давайте ее поприветствуем. Ты можешь, хотя девчонка большая. Пойдем ближе. Нет? Хорошо. Лучше бы поддержали, а не смеялись. Аплодисмент. Ох так. Я замолкаю. Два раза чуть не прилетело ведущему. Много говоришь. И третий. Есть. Не впустую пришла. Как вас зовут?
Дарья.
Дарья, аплодисменты поддержим? Да, конечно. Три попытки. Волнительно, еще раз аплодисменты. Но удар поставлен. Есть. Кто у нас два раза, да, забили? Здрасте, это вам. Пойдемте все вместе со мной, крикнем вперед, Надежда. Пойдемте вот сюда, здесь нас много. Готовы? Я скажу 1, 2, 3, вы вместе со мной крикните вперед, Надежда. 1, 2, 3! Ваши аплодисменты! Ну что ж, буквально через 7 минут мы вновь вернемся на площадку, на большой баскетбол. We'll be right back.
Hello again from Orenburg in Russia. We're almost at the end of the half-time interval in game one of the quarter-final clash in the Women's EuroLeague, the FIBA Women's EuroLeague between Odessa Orenburg and Dinamo Kursk. The home side in yellow, they lead 34-32. Good comeback from them, they trailed by quite a few points in the first quarter. They were trailing 13-18 after 10 minutes, but they won the second quarter 21-14, and that equates to a two-point lead at half-time. So here we go, it is Dinamo Kursk in possession, trailing by two, beginning of the third quarter. Osipova. Ogumiki in the corner. Jakobsen almost dropped the ball there. And, well, she beat the shot clock buzzer but didn't score. So, Nadezhda Orenburg looking to increase their lead. Well, they get the rebound and it's a four-point lead again. And 33 is Natalia Andonkina. And she moves on. Well, her team move on to a four-point lead. Well, the attempted backdoor is highly unsuccessful. The good denial of the pass inside by Nadezhda Orenburg. Adnika has now moved on to 12 points, equal leading the score in the game, equal with the lady who just passed the ball off there, Ogumiki. Harding inside to Osipova, Osipova the layup. 6 points now to the veteran Russian. Osipova began the first quarter well, and she's done the same in the third. McBride. Ogumiki's doing a good job on Dewana Bonner. Robinson inside, lost the ball. And somehow got the drop well. Robinson. Everyone held their breath, and one or two spectators sucked the ball in then. I wondered why the ball, the score had been frozen on 37, but it's back to a two-point game. As Endine Mayem hits the jumper. Very early to say, but this game could have wire written all over it. As Dewana Bonner yet to score a field goal. Anna Cruz inside, finds Robinson. McBride. Shot clock low. McBride pulls up and hits the three. That's just the second three-pointer from a team renowned for shooting pretty poorly from the arc. Was it a two, was it a three? Jakobsen inside, good hands. And that came off Osipova's fingertips. Good deflection there. It was indeed a three-pointer a moment ago. So, Dinamo Kursk trailing by five now. The biggest lead for Nadezhda. Well, something, a little problem with the table here. Yeah, asking whether that was a three or a two. It was indeed a three, yeah. Coach Roberto Iniguez there. 48-year-old Spaniard. Just making sure that that three was correctly given. So Robinson to Cruz. McBride with Jakobsen in close attention. Robinson almost dropped it. He was about to shoot, I think. Robinson! Terrific hustling there. And Lindsay Harding had a man on her back and kept her there. Osipova. Oh, that's terrific team defense from Nadezhda Orenburg. Ogumiki was surrounded then. Well, we talk about shot selection in this great game of basketball, but that was poor pass selection then by Kursk, passing to a player who was triple teamed almost. Osipova. Five on the shot clock. Ogumiki inside. Oh, how on earth did Ogumiki score then? Oh, such a tough upper frame. And inside McBride, instant response. Tyler McBride goes inside, then sprints, though a life depended upon it. Here's Harding. Ogumiki for three, Ogumiki! Wow, what a game she's having, 15 points. Actually, I think it's 17. Yeah, she was on 12 at half time and 5 in this second half so far, and she's reduced the arrears to 2. McBride. And the rebound is Robinson, and the recycle as well to Bonner. Bonner for three. Still no field goal for Dawana Bonner. Possibly her worst offensive output in many a game, but she's got 7 rebounds. Harding. Ogumiki. Jakobsen pulls over the jumper. And the rebound is Angelica Robinson. Robinson now has 10 points and 9 rebounds. And Dawana Bonner, her first field goal of the game, and possibly the easiest score she'll have in a long time. Jakobsen into Ogumiki. Oh, around the rim and out. And here's Dawana Bonner. Ana Cruz. 4.5 to go in the third. Cruz pulls up for the jumper. And that was out of bounds. Natalia Antokina there chased the rebound down, but bounced it on the end line. Tatiana Widmar, number 8, back in for Dynamo Kursk. Widmar, no points, 2 rebounds so far for the veteran Russian. Ogumiki, a bullet-like pass. And the rebound is Ana Cruz, and off to the fast break. And then regroups in the half court. That's a tough pass to make to Anakina. He got there though. Here's Cruz again. Anakina. For two, Natalia Anakina, who's on to 14 points. Leading scorer for Nadezhda. Harding, oh, waiting for the player to say bye-bye and then buried the jumper. Cool play from Lindsay Harding for her 8th point. Oh, don't go back. McBride. Taking it inside, gets a shot well and truly blocked. I think that the first shot block from either side.
Substitution in Dynamo, number 77 is in. Substitution in Nadezhda, number 13 is in.
McBride. Looking for Robinson. McBride off to the three instead. He's chased down by Bonner. New 14, he clipped the rim. That's the travel. Travel there by Beglova. Elena Beglova. Oh, what's going to be the foul on the play?
Замена в команде «Надежда». На площадку вышла Алена Кириллова, номер 9.
There was indeed a foul on the play.
Немкадия Агвумики, номер 30, третий фол.
Немкадия Агвумики, номер 30,
третий фол. Беглова. Trying to get it into Robinson. Nice pass, and the pass, and again, Natalia Venikina. 18 points now to the number 33 for Nadezhda Orenburg. And she's averaging 4.8 points a game, would you believe? Jakobsen. Well, the easy two there, lovely pass from Jakobsen. And that is number 77. And that is Anastasia Loganova. Nice little bounce pass. Not this time, though, for Anakina. Bet she gets the rebound. That's a poor pass, and well read indeed by Vidmar, Tatiana Vidmar. And the foul to stop the break, the reaching foul. The reaching foul by Elena Beglova. Superb reading of the pass there from Tatiana Vidmar. Vidmar in the World Championships in 2010 was top in steals, blocks and assists. That's the number 8 for Dinamo Kerr. Just got another steal. McBride doing a good job on Ogumiki, but Ogumiki steps in, and the rebound by Angelica Robinson, and the foul. Well, the travel actually by Angelica Robinson. The Montenegrin passport holder, Angelica Robinson, got a terrific rebound there, but traveled. That's the expression, if looks good kill. We've got dead referee now. ...110 seconds remaining in the third. Ogumiki. Nice little weave out the top for Dinamo Kursk. Jakobsen. And Vidmar for the jump shot. Gets her shot blocked by Angelica Robinson. That's a make up for a travel by Robinson. And then the turnover. So nervous signs for both teams here. With 91 seconds remaining in the third.
Динамо. На площадку вышла Людмила Сапова, номер 14.
Substitution in Динамо, number 14 is in.
Людмила Сапова back in for Динамо Кырск, number 14. Ogumiki to inbound to Lindsay Harding. Ogumiki. Harding. That's a lovely move from Anastasia Loganova, number 77. 25 years of age, signed from Castelbrian, Brain in Belgium. They're no longer in European competition, so she signed for Kursk, and the steal there.
Last minute of the third.
Harding. Well, Harding there, bounced the ball through her legs, and on the break, the two, the jump shot, the pull-up jump shot, is by Elena Kirilova, and it's back to a four-point lead for Nadezhda Orenburg, 30 seconds remaining in the third, here's Harding. Coach Iniguez on his feet, where he's been for most of the game indeed. Vidmar to Ogumiki. Oh, inside, what a move, what footwork, indeed, from Anastasia Loganova. Well, fitting in very nicely with her new team. 4 seconds left, and there's a foul on the play by the lady who just scored at the other end, Anastasia Loganova. Two points, 6 seconds remaining, third quarter. Now this is where we were at half-time with Nadezhda Orenburg leading by two. Right out the last 2.5 seconds of the quarter. Now what have Nadezhda Orenburg region got in the 2.5 second playbook? Gotta be quick. Well, that's good defense, particularly from Lindsay Harding. It's a 2-point lead for Nadezhda Orenburg over Dinamo Kursk after 3 quarters. We'll be right back. watching highlights of the third quarter in this quarterfinal of the FIBA Women's EuroLeague playoff. Let me remind you what's at stake here. This is a best of three situation in the quarterfinals. The first team to win two games goes to the final four. If it's 2-0, there is no need for a third game. But this is only the first game. Home game for Dinamo Kursk will be on Friday, and you can see that on livebasketball.tv. If a third game is required, it'll be next Wednesday. You can almost taste the tension here in Orenburg. So almost ready for the start of the fourth quarter. It is Nadezhda Orenburg in possession. Elena Kirillova inbounds. Is again. The team leading by two. Kelly McBride to Dewana Bonner, who has just one field goal to her name. She still has one, but what a rebound there from Angelica Robinson. That's her 10th rebound. The number four on Nadezhda, Angelica Robinson, 10 points, 10 rebounds.
Tatiana Widmer,
and she has two foul shots to come.
Tatiana Widmer, number eight, second foul.
Angelica Robinson is a 64% foul shooter. Well, it gets a little less than 64 now. Well, she gets the drop.
Robinson!
So the lead three. Robinson moves on to 11 points to go with her 10 rebounds. Harding. Elderbrink. Wow, the dribble. The bounce is too high, really, from Anastasia Loganova. She lost control of it. Loganova, 6 points for her new team. Recently arrived from Belgium. A turnover there against her. Bonner under no pressure. Kirillova. Bonner inside. And she's fouled. She's got another two foul shots. I think this is the fourth time she's been on the foul line tonight.
Замена в команде Надежды. На площадку вернулась Анна Круз, номер 15.
Back in for Nadezhda Orenburg, Anna Cruz, 29-year-old Spaniard.
Frida Elderbrink, second fall.
And Frida Elderbrink, one of the Elderbrink twins, both play for Sweden. Just picked up the foul. Juana Bonner, I'm in a quiet-ish game. Boston 2 for a lead of 4.
Замена в команде Динамо. На площадке Мкади Агвумики, номер 30.
Агвумики back in, number 30. Leading scorer for them, she's on 17 points.
Number 30 is in.
And here's Lindsay Harding. Well, no real pressure on the perimeter from Nadezhda, and disappointed look on the face there of Anastasia Loganova. That's the second turnover in quick succession. She bounced it on the end line. So her bang, she goes out to be replaced by Andine Miam. Kayla McBride back in. Corner Desda. Here's Anna Cruz. Robinson to Bonner. 13 is Beglova. Cruz inside. Oh, she got the drop. Wonderful cut by Anna Cruz. And now the lead 6. Corner Desda. Jakobsen. Harding pulls up, reduces the Urias to 4. Lindsay Harding now on 8 points to go with her 7 rebounds and 3 assists. Oh, the turnover, wretched turnover there from Beglova. almost a blind pass. Yeah, good work from Widmar. And good teamwork from Annette Jakobsen. Here's Harding. Jakobsen to Harding. Mayem. Oh, that's great hands. And we have a 2-1. Bonner pulls up for the jumper and hits Dawana Bonner. And she punches the air and a big grin breaks out on the face of Dawana Bonner, 28-year-old American. And we have a timeout called by Gundersvetter, coach of Dynamo Kursk. Tell you that in the other quarter final being played at the moment, Iket Çınarburg against Galatasaray. The home side Iket are leading 62-50 in the fourth quarter. Of course, that is also best of three situation. And there's the layup from Dawana Bonner, and she punches the air. I make that Dawana Bonner 8 points to her now, and 8 rebounds. And the two field goals that Dawana Bonner have scored have been pretty simple affairs. Both easy, uncontested layups. Now what can Dynamo Kursk do coming out of their timeout? 57 plays 51. Some Kursk fans here, they've come a long way. And at the moment their team trailing by 6. Of course, on Friday, the teams go to Kursk for game 2. Jakobsen. Harding. Ogwumiki travels. Yeah, she changed her pivot foot. The old adage, not many referees follow. If it looks wrong, it probably is. And that did look decidedly awkward. The referee just wants to make sure the court is safe. And the Desert Orenburg want to make sure that their lead is safe. They're leading by 6. Excellent crowd here in Orenburg. It's Beglova. Bonner. Back to Beglova. McBride. Shot clock on 6. And the foul. Tatiana Widmar. And you have to say that Elena Beglova probably not going too far there, looking for the foul and getting it. Surrounded by players a lot taller than her. And they bailed her out. Beglova, no points as yet. And that changes immediately. The lead now 7. Two from two for Beglova. Well, she's only scored 4 from 6 so far. But now she's on 6 for 8 from the foul line in this competition this year. Harding with a team trailing by 8. Jakobsen. Widmar. Ogwumiki. And that shot is blocked. Wonderful play by Angelica Robinson. She blocked the shot and got the loose ball. And on the break, it is 21, Kayla McBride. It's a 10-point lead for Nadezhda Orenburg. Remember that Dynamo Kursk just had a timeout. Brilliant defense from Nadezhda Orenburg. Harding pulls up and hits the jumper for her 12th point. Keeping Dynamo Kursk within touching distance, just about. Here's Beglova, Robinson, McBride. Patient play, here's Anna Cruz. That's not patient though. But how on earth, Dawana Bonner picks it up again! That's her third simple layup, and then she steals the ball to Wanabana. I don't think any of her teammates realised she'd stolen the ball. Disaster there for Dinamo Kursk. Anna Cruz taking her time here. Cruz inside. McBride for three! Tyler McBride hits the three! And the worst three-point shooting team in the competition now leads by 13! Dinamo Kursk are forced to call their second timeout in next to no time. Carla McBride, 14 points now, including that big three. There's one of the simple layups for Dawana Bonner. Dawana Bonner has very quietly moved on to 10 points with three pretty easy field goals. What have Dinamo Kursk got in terms of a comeback? Well, actually, that's a good foul. Tatiana Widmer stole the ball and then was fouled, and the pass break was stopped in its tracks. The pull-up shot there for Elena Beglova. Well, I'm getting my Elena's mixed up. That was actually Elena Kirilova. Well, coach Roberto Iniguez knows this game is not done yet. His team leads 66-53. Still a long time to go in the fourth quarter. But Dinamo Kursk have only one timeout remaining. And Beglova is all over Harding. Here's Harding again. The margin at the end of the game is irrelevant. All the team wants is a win in the best of three. Nice pass inside. And that is the first score for a long time from Nika Agumiki. She moves on to 19 points, leading scorer of the game. Here's Beglova again to Robinson. McBride. McBride inside for two. Great penetration from Kyla McBride. She moves on to 16 points. Just to the three and then a really hard penetrating layup for Kyla McBride. The lead back to 13. There's a foul on the play, holding foul. It's against Dawana Bonner, I think. Number 24. Coach Roberto Iniguez politely asking for a clarification. Now, was it a technical foul or an unsportsmanlike? It was a technical foul. Was that Dawana Bonner? It was indeed, and Dawana Bonner offers her apologies to the coach. Whatever she said, the referee took exception to it. Dawana Bonner says no, leave me out there. The lead back to 12. And possession to Dinamo Kursk. Jakobsen to inbound to Harding. No idea what Dawana Bonner said then, but probably quite tasty, I would think. Mayhem inside. The three is good. Dinamo Kursk well and truly back in the game. And that is Ludmila Sapova. Well, it was 13. It is now 8. Make it 9. And the foul by Dinamo Kursk. Foul, Annette Jakobsen.
Annette Jakobsen, number 12, второй foul.
Annette Jakobsen, number 12, second foul.
Команда Динамо набрала 4 командных фаула.
Anna Cruz.
Динамо has 14
fouls. Vastly experienced Spanish international, well capable of running the clock down here. Inside to Bonner. Bonner on the turnaround, good footwork. And Dawana Bonner gets the drop again. She's come alive in the second half. Dawana Bonner. 14 points to her now and 8 rebounds. And the lead back to 11 for Nadezhda Orenburg. Lindsay Harding. Jakobsen. Sapova's just hit 1-3, make it 2! Людмила Сапова there, only averaging 2.4 points a game.
Надежда takes time out.
And she's on 6 points tonight, all of them from the arc. Time out. Надежда Оренбург. Dinamo Kursk refusing to lie down here. They have trailed by 13. Now it's only 8. And 29-year-old Людмила Сапова, number 14 for Dinamo Kursk, just hit 2-3 pointers to get them well and truly back in the game. But Anna Cruz there taking it to the hole and laying it up. She is again, same play. The one up on her pulls up for the jumper. Almost the thing of the past, the pull up jump shot. Ogumiki there, good footwork, but it's a trial. It wasn't good footwork indeed, it was travelling. 8 points to lead for Надежда Оренбург region over Dinamo Kursk. Coach of Надежда there making his point. Some pressure now up the floor from Dinamo Kursk. Anna Cruz handles it with consummate ease. Cruz to Beglova. Bride. Bocca. Bride. Well, the line there misses by a long way. Possession to Dinamo Kursk. 3:20 to go in the fourth. Lindsay Harding. Remember that Kursk have not beaten Надежда in the Russian League this season. Lost both games. Here's Jakobsen. Bonner steals the ball and isn't quickest down the floor. Jakobsen inside, and she's fouled. It's a two-shot foul. The foul, Anna Cruz. Yeah, it's just tickled the elbow of the shooter. Jakobsen, a vastly experienced Latvian player, is a WNBA champion in 2014. But she's not been to the foul line too many times this season so far. No matter. Great technique from the great Latvian player. It's back to 9. Actually, it's back to 7, I think. That should tick up to 62,
Anna Cruz,
I think.
Anna Cruz, number 15, second fall.
Anna Cruz, number 15, second fall.
Just checking the foul count. It's Anna Cruz. That's the second. And Coach Iniguez there looking a little perturbed now. Yeah, the referee's just being very patient, sorting out any problems with the table, just making sure who got the foul and who's in the penalty, etc. And at Jakobsen being made to wait here. She hit the first. I think that should tick up to 70-63. It does indeed. 3 to go in the fourth. Game 1 of the FIBA Women's EuroLeague, the playoffs. And it's the last thing that Dinamo Kursk needed. A delay in the play, but you've got to get the electronics, you've got to get every small detail right. In such a tight game. The Kursk fans, they know how important it is. They could somehow escape with a road win, and they would feel extremely happy taking it back to Kursk. Well, our apologies for the delay in play here, but you'll understand that the table and the officials, the referees, have to get it exactly right. So much at stake. We won't know which team will go to the Final Four after this game. We may know after the game played in Kursk on Friday. First team to win 2 games goes to the Final Four. a bit of tension on the faces of the fans here in Orenburg. It is Nadezhda Orenburg 70, Dynamo Kursk 63 with one foul shot to come. And that will be taken by Annette Jakobsen Zagota. Jakobsen averaging 15 points a game. She's on 6 points so far tonight. And here she is with a second foul shot. That should tick up to 63, I'm sure. It should now be 64. Anna Cruz. Well, I think it should be 64. We'll get clarification on that. Bonner, inside and outside. Oh, wide open! Oh, goodness me! A wide open shot, and it's missed. Goodness me. She seemed to have so much time. And that, Natalia Adonica. And a great shot block there from Angelica Robinson, and she has the good graciousness to pick her opponent up. I mean, just almost flattened her. So, under 2.5 to go. We'll stay with the main scoreboard at 70-63. Of course, that announcer getting very, very excited, and Ogumiki gets a shot blocked, and Ogumiki McBride to Cruz. Cruz will slow things down. McBride goes inside and off the glass. Kyla McBride for her 20 points, most of them in the second half. She makes it a 9-point game again with two remaining. 2 minutes, that is. Ogumiki. Jakobsen, a nice pass. And another block shot from Natalia Anakini. No, it's a foul by 33.
Natalia Anakini.
Natalia Anakini, number 33, for fall.
And on the foul line, Nika Ogumiki for her 20th point. It's back to an 8-point game with 106 seconds remaining in regulation. Only one from two, and the rebound. Anakina. Anna Cruz. Cruz will run the clock religiously. And finds McBride. McBride defended by Jakobsen. Robinson inside for the left-handed layup. It's back to a 10-point game. 80 seconds remaining. Angelica Robinson moves on to 13 points to go with her 11 rebounds. And Dawana Bonner, well, had the wind knocked out of her.
Немкаджи Агумики, номер 30, 4-й фол.
There was a foul on the play. There was indeed. And it was after the score. So Dawana Bonner on the foul line for two shots. She's on 12 points to go with her 8 rebounds. Now was that her second steal? 81 seconds remaining in regulation. The home side leading by 11. 13 points now. Good second half for Dawana Bonner after going without a field goal in the second half. Two from two. That should just about do it, one suspects. As we have a timeout called by Gunders Vetra. Third timeout by Dynamo Kursk. They're in trouble. 76 plays 64. Remember, it's only game one of the FIBA Women's EuroLeague. That's a terrific fast break there from Nadezhda Orenburg. Kyla McBride, what a second half she's had. A tally, I think it's 20 points, 2 points, 1 assist, no fouls. That's number 21, Nadezhda Orenburg. Well, I can't clear up what happened with that technical foul, but it doesn't seem to have had an effect on the game. Long three-pointer there. That was Ludmila Sapova. She hit two from the arc. Well, if this continues the way it is, then Dinamo Kursk will have to win the next two games to make the final four. One of those games will be in Kursk. If they don't win that game in Kursk, they'll have to... they will have given up any possibility of getting to the final four, because Nadezhda Orenburg will have won two games, but that's a big if. Harding to inbound for Dinamo Kursk, who trail by 12. Now there's a foul on the play, trying to deny Nika Ogumiki the ball inside there. But Nadezhda Orenburg not yet in the penalty. I think that was their fourth. And Dinamo Kursk has been in the penalty some time. Ogumiki against McBride. And McBride is deemed to have fouled her. Well, McBride there walks to the bench and apologises. That's only a first foul.
Second.
Kari Ogumiki from Stanford University. First round pick, first round of the draft in 2012. It's the first. 22 points now. Possibly on the losing side, unless you have a miracle or two. Two from two for Ogumiki. Beglova will no doubt run the clock here. She certainly will. Duana Bonner. Ooh, almost traveled there. No doubt what, no idea what Anna Cruz is trying to do there. The kind of overhead hook pass into the corner to McBride. And all she does is find someone in the first row of the bleachers. 10 points, the lead for Nadezhda Orenburg. In the last minute, here's Jakobsen. Jakobsen taking it inside. Sapova, she's got to shoot the three, surely. Jakobsen will. Misses. And the rebound. Another rebound, another rebound. Another 3-pointer. Great pass from Harding. She finds Ndimbiam. It's an 8-point game now with 31 seconds remaining. And timeout called by Nadezhda Orenburg region coach Roberto Inuvez. Surely Nadezhda cannot give up 8 points in the last 31 seconds. Jakobsen on the foul line. That put her on 7 points. And a block there from Angelica Robinson. She made 2 blocks in less than 60 seconds. Crucial blocks at that. I can tell you, in the other quarterfinal being played at this very moment, Ekaterinburg are leading Galatasaray by 16 points late in the fourth. So Galatasaray, well, an awesome time. They have to win in Turkey and then come back to Russia to beat Ekat. And not many teams do that. And the same will apply to Dinamo Kursk. I suspect they'll have to win in Kursk and then come back here to Orenburg. Now, courtside announcer getting very, very excited with his team leading 76-68 with just over 30 seconds remaining in the fourth. There's Carla McBride. What a great second half she had. McBride on 20 points actually. And here she is attempting to receive it. No, it gets in the hands of Anna Cruz, who is immediately double teamed and the foul. Quick foul by Jakobsen. And Dinamo Kursk has been in the penalty for some time. First quarter Kursk led by 5, but then the second quarter, Nedezda won by 7. The third quarter was tied at 17s, but Nedezda significant 25-19 in this fourth quarter. Anna Cruz hits the first. Cruz moves on to 7 points, but more importantly, 3 rebounds and 3 assists for the Spanish international. 2 from 2 there, the lead back to 10.
They
have a substitution. We can't have a timeout call by Kursk. They've run out of timeouts.
Substitution in Nadezhda. Number 4 is in.
Angelica Robinson back in for the home side. Robinson on 13 points. A terrific double-double. She's got 11 rebounds. There's Jakobsen. And Dewana Bonner chases it down. Well, nothing dropping for Dynamo Kursk. That should be it with 7 seconds remaining. It is Nedezda Orenburg leading Dynamo Kursk by 10. So in a best of three series, Nedezda Orenburg lead 1-0 as the Dewana Bonner punches the air. Well, it's been a great game one in a possible three-game series. The Nedezda Orenburg region have beaten Dynamo Kursk 78-68. My apologies for the courtside announcer getting very, very excited, understandably so. The fans celebrate, the cheerleaders celebrate. The only people not celebrating are Dynamo Kursk, who have to win the next two games to make it to the final four, because Nedezda Orenburg have won this game 78-68. They take a 1-0 series lead in a possible three-game series. Wonderful game from the number 34 Dynamo Kursk, Nika Ogumiki, 22 points and 5 rebounds. But on the losing side, Angelica Robinson, a terrific double-double, number 4 for Nadizda, 13 points, 11 rebounds. No one else got a double-double. Lindsay Harding was close with 10 points and 9 rebounds. That's the number 4, the guard for Dynamo Kursk. Ogumiki, 22 points and 5 rebounds. Dewana Bonner, 14 points, 8 rebounds. And a surprise package, perhaps, of Nedezda Orenburg was Natalia Anoikina, number 33, 16 points and 3 rebounds for a girl, a lady rather, who averages 4.8 points a game. So it is Nedezda Orenburg who have beaten Dynamo Kursk 78-68, and it is the team from Orenburg who take a 1-0 lead in the series.
16 марта в случае необходимости состоится третий матч четвертьфинала. Начало в 19:00. В случае необходимости третий матч четвертьфинала Евролига. Надежда против команды Динамо Курск. 16 марта. Начало в 7 вечера. Ну и по традиции прямо сейчас состоится автограф-сессия с любимыми игроками. Прямо сейчас я прошу обратить ваше внимание на большой экран.
поскольку прямо сейчас там появятся номера счастливчиков, которые заберут сертификаты от наших партнеров. Номера, пожалуйста, выведите на экран. В большом перерыве мы крутили лототрон, и номера абонементов 4092, 3153. Если есть таковые в зале, пожалуйста, подойдите. У меня есть для вас подарок. Также номера билетов 30-83-05-21-22-101 и номер 30-81-39-59-84-204. Здравствуйте. Покажите, пожалуйста. Все честно. И номера оранжевых корешков по сувенирке 30350.